I'm telling all of you, we must see every police officer and every army personnel deployed to Biafra land as our enemy. Every policeman, every army we see is our enemy. Because how do we know which one is a terrorist recruited by El Rufai into the army? From not even local terrorists, from Mali, from Senegal, from Gambia, from Niger. How do we know? If you are in the army or police, leave Biafra land. Burn your uniform. Burn it. I told you I will draw your army to the east. As I draw your army into the east, terrorists will occupy your land, and it's going to happen. Because I know you have stupid pride and ego. You will take the bet because you are full and you are foolish. You will take this bet I'm handing over to you. You will come to Biafra land there. We are going to kill you. You will die in Biafra land. You are going to perish there. Your army will die in Biafra land. Fulani Empire, the end of Fulani Caliphate will start from Biafra land. It will start from Oulu. I assure you, it starts from Oulu. The end of Fulani Caliphate in Sokoto will begin in Oulu. Write it down somewhere. I told you this very day. I'm going to reply Omahi through a quote by Emiliano Zapata. We do not want the peace of slaves, nor the peace of the grave. Do you understand that? Fulani must leave our land. Biafra must be declared with full, uninterrupted sovereignty. Biafra is what we're looking for. Nothing more. If you're looking for people to bribe, you are mistaken. We are unbribable. We are unbribable. We don't need anything from anybody. We are asking for Biafra, and Biafra we're going to get. Or we all die in the process. I assure you of that. These are the same people that called Jules Okalo gave land to at Lopa, that kidnapped some students of APSU a few days ago. And of course, we know what we did. And they're very smart sometimes. They quickly released all of them. All of the army, Nigerian army in Biafra land, you are going to die there. You will die in Biafra land. All of you will die there. What our people don't understand this very message that we are giving to them. But I do hope that after tonight, they will get it. Things can never be the same again in Nigeria. Is gone. The zoo called Nigeria is gone. It can never be the same again. There are arms everywhere. Arms everywhere. It can never be the same. The same thing the army has, now the people they have it as well. Is it not AK-47? Ordinary bullet. You have it. And we have it. Let us see who is going to give up. We outnumber you by over 100,000 to one. Even if we sacrifice 10 lives for one of you, we will kill all of you. That is why I know that Biafra land is a death trap for the zoo. They can never get out of there alive. They will die in that very place.
Nigeria only has 250,000 men under arms. Only 250,000 men under arms. When I went to Omaba in Onitsha, the crowd that came to see me, the young men that came to Omaba in Onitsha, outnumber Nigerian army. God and them. I mean, it's incredible, isn't it? They know they're fighting a losing battle you can never win. Pharaoh made the same mistake. And God will use Nigeria and Britain as an example to the whole world that Biafrans are his children. By the time God, the anger of God is done upon Nigeria, believe you me, oh God, if you see a Biafran, start running. Anybody who supports one Nigeria is your enemy. Is your enemy. They are gaining something from you. They don't want you to be free. That person is your enemy. And you must fight that very person with the last thing that you have in your possession. If Fulani, they think they are stubborn. You went to APSU to go and take students. You think you are stubborn. We know where you took them to. I gave you 48 hours within 24, you released them. I know you should, hold on to them now. Come, go to your community, okay, man. Hold on to them, you will see what will happen to you. You are telling me that a killer brought in by El Rufai can be killing people in Southern Kaduna? They arrest him, or they catch him, or he decides to repent. Now he is in the army, and he's in Oulu killing people. Oh, Chineken, God in heaven. I don't know who they are, But I support a non-gun man. I don't know who they are, but I pray for them and I support them. This is the question I want to ask Nigerian government in the court of law anywhere in the world. How do you know that those they deployed in our law are not terrorists? How do you know that in uniform? How do you know? Under your watch, you marry for 6 years. Niyetiala, your friends, we are busy killing our people in Ebonyi. You did nothing. Instead, you encouraged them against your own people. When IPOB rose up 4 years ago to challenge them, you sent the police and the army to go and kill people. Those defending your land. You sent the police and the army to go and kill people. You sent the police and the army to go and kill people. I am glad that today, Dave Umahi with his mouth has confessed that no more Miyeti Ala terrorists in Ebonyi State. Who made it possible, I ask of you? Who made it possible, I ask of you? The volunteer command of indigenous people of Biafra. Now, Eastern Security Network, you understand that? We drove away the fourth most deadly terror group in the world away from Ebonyi State. Something Umahi could not do. Something no governor could have done. We did it ourselves. Of course, by the grace of the Most High Elohim up in heaven. Today, you are boasting. We don't have any more Mietiana. No headsmen in Ebonyi State. Who made it possible, I ask of you? If you are in the army or police, leave Biafra land. Burn your uniform. Burn it. Burn your uniform because...
Anyway, let me not go too far.
I want to ask Daily Trust newspaper, Premium Times. These are Fulani newspapers. How do we distinguish between a genuine Nigerian soldier and a terrorist from Mali wearing army uniform that claim he or she has repented? It's a simple question. Because we come from Nigeria, John Agyefuzo. I mean, it's a very simple question. How do we know that army on a checkpoint? How do we know if they are terrorists or not? So explain that to me. Because you people are the ones bringing terrorists into the army and into the police. How do we know? You see, you can never win against us. None of you can win against us. How can we distinguish between a genuine army or police officer and those terrorists from the Sahel that El Rufai and the Fulani Cabal, Fulani Caliphate brought in to take over our land from us, whose intention from the onset is to do us harm? How do we know? They are now in the army, they are now in the police. That is why all army and police units deployed to Biafra land must be seen as enemies. Nobody at the defense headquarters of Nigeria, the National Assembly, no governor, no sophisticated moron, no efulefu can tell us who is a genuine soldier and who is a Fulani terrorist turned into a soldier. Nobody can tell us. Nobody can tell us. This is the mess. This is the mess the world must come to terms with, because we do not know who is a terrorist in the army or police uniform. Therefore, all of them are terrorists to us. All of them are terrorists. These Fulani government are the ones that brought terrorism into the army. They integrated terrorists into the army. Now you understand why they decided to deploy exclusively Fulani officers to lead the invasion and occupation of Oulu and parts of Biafra land. Let me ask the Sergeant Fulani, the Supreme Court Administrator of Imo State, and the Judge Obiozo, and the cocaine snorting Mrs. Tambuwal of River State. How are you sure these Fulani soldiers you are requesting to come and protect you does not contain the same Fulani terrorists that set out from the Sahel to kill you in the first place? You people are beyond stupid. You people are beyond idiots. I'm telling you the truth. Fulani Islamist politicians have destroyed the territorial integrity of Nigeria. They are the ones that brought in their fellow terrorists from across the Sahel into Nigeria. Without proper documentation at the border. They're coming from Sokoto, from Katsina, from Kano, from everywhere across the north. They're coming with their AK-47, or they acquire one once they get into the zoo. They now go on a kidnapping spree and ransom spree. They leave this place, they leave the zoo as multi-billionaires. Nobody is asking the federal government of the Republic of Nigeria how I've been waiting for this question every day. How did they get in?
Who lets them in?
Nobody talks about these things. How did they manage to get to Kaduna? To a polytechnic? To go and take people who are in a polytechnic?
How? How manage? They cannot ask these pertinent questions. Not a single one of them. They send their army, their zombie army, to the east, where they will be destroyed by Elohim. Then the sun will rise over the land of Biafra, never to dim again for eternity. It was today that the full weight of that message that I was giving dawned on me. When I was on air and I was saying that we'll draw them to the east, and the real bad eggs will take over their land, I didn't even know what I was saying, but it has happened today. Do you know who Kebbi people are?
You don't know, but I will tell you later.
The people who are in Olu today fighting, most of them are from Kebbi State. In the Nigerian army. They came to Olu to kill their farm people. But as they left the north, their lands are being taken over by hardened savages and animals from across the Sahel that their political masters imported into the zoo. All of the army, Nigerian army in Biafra land, you are going to die there. You will die in Biafra land. All of you will die in Biafra land, those in Olu, those elsewhere. The best option for you is to take off your uniform and run away before it is too late. Go back to your land, those of you from Kebbi State. Go back to Kebbi to go and save your land. Because as you are in Olu, you have no village anymore to go back to in Kebbi. It's gone. Your village is gone and gone for good. That is the work of Almighty God in heaven. The same prophecy I was given, that there is no other religious minister in the zoo that can match 0.0000001% of the accuracy of our prediction. No, nobody can. I'm begging.
Now listen carefully to me. All of you in Biafra land, you're going to die. Even the Pakistani mercenaries that we saw in Olu, all of you will die there. If by any stretch of luck you manage to survive what is coming, because they know now, and I watch it in Agesugo.
If by any stretch of imagination you get out of Olu alive and survive what is coming,
then look for where else to go to, because your land has been taken over by terrorists from the Sahel. Those of you from Kebbi State in Imo State listening to my broadcast this evening, you are about to pay the price of stupidity. In your next life, if they mention Biafra, you will tell your mother not to give birth to you. All of you, you are finished. You are going to die in the one thing. You are going to die in Biafra land. You will die there, to start with. All of you will die there. You will die in Biafra land. You are going to die there. That is certain. The same people that you proscribed, the same indigenous people of Biafra, you're not ashamed of yourself. You are looking for good to negotiate. You're a fool. You're a complete fool. I am glad I have confessed. The same IPOB volunteers and ESN you despise so much. If any of you Efulefus think that allowing Fulani terrorists into our land guarantees you a path to Asorok, then you are more foolish than I thought. None of you Igbo politicians will smile at Asorok. None of you will ever go to Asorok. You will never go to Asorok. Never, ever, ever. No Igbo, if you like, you try and see now. Of course, there will be no campaign, so talk less about that rubbish. None of you will smile at Asorok. Since all of you came out to gang up against Biafra, none of you will ever smell us up. None of you will. It's like a Ogun or Korea. The same politics of appeasement of Azikiwe that landed us in the mess we are in today is what you want to play again, only this time around with the very worst the foreign race has to offer, which is the terrorism in Miyet Yala. Shame on all of you cowards masquerading as defenders of the people. Shame on all of you pastors claiming your preaching the word of God. You are all serpents, all of you, Ndoshi. Today, you fools are condemning the holy saints on non-gunmen. You have forgotten that you people created them.
when you were killing young people, slaughtering them left, right, and center, you don't know the one that they will rise up? Is that what you think? Is that what you're thinking? One day they will rise and have risen up. One day they will rise. If you kill them, they will kill you. If you kill them, they will kill you. The killing will continue until you leave our land. It can never stop. It can never, ever stop, I assure you. You fools are condemning unknown gunmen. But when you were killing people, you were enjoying it. At some all you slaughtered. At Enugu, you killed. Igbocha, you killed. National High School, but you killed. You think we can fold our hands? You keep killing for eternity? Now you know you bleed as well. That thing you have, we have it. You kill us, we kill you. You arrest us, we're going to arrest your children. Anything you want, we give you. Because it is Biafra or death. Biafra or we all die. Get in Biafra. I remember how they were jubilating. When people were being forced to drink dirty water, they were jubilating. You did not call your army to order. You did not call your police to order. Now people are angry. You're writing your usual junk. What will kill Fulani is hubris. Hubris will kill you. They said they're coming to Allah to come and do shoot at sight in Allah. And I say, hallelujah. Hallelujah, bring it on. Come to Allah and do shoot at sight and go free. Come and do it now, let us see. Come and do shoot at sight. I am praying for it. Come and do shoot at sight. Come and do shoot at sight. I said to you before, you don't understand how mad we are about Biafra. I will sacrifice anything for Biafra. Are you prepared to do something for Nigeria? Will you do the same for Nigeria? I'm asking you. Will you do the same for Nigeria? I'm asking you. Will you do the same for this zoological republic? Anything you want, we give to you. Come and do your shoot at sight. Come now, we are waiting. Come and do it in Alu. Then you will see hell. You haven't seen nothing yet. What you're seeing now and you're complaining, you are about to see more. Since some of them map refers to this shoot at sight, I am asking their friends tonight to prepare for all-out war. Because if they carry out this very threat, every APC person in the East will go down. If you're in APC, I don't care. If you're Igbo, you're Yoruba, I don't care where you come from. If you're in the East, you will go down. Let them carry this shit aside. Let them carry it out. Every APC politician will die. I assure you of that. In Nupe land, Nupe in Niger State, Nupe land is flowing with blood every blessed day. Do you know what DSS said? DSS wrote a memo. The same DSS kidnapping people everywhere in the East. Do you know that DSS wrote a memo asking Niger people not to panic, that the boundaries are passing their area, not to panic? Are you aware of that? Are you aware of that? That they wrote saying, oh, bandits are passing your area, you don't have to panic. But in our land, they are kidnapping people. The same DSS are busy kidnapping people. But in Niger State, DSS, Department for State Security, or SSS, they are busy giving passageway to terrorists who have come to kill you. And you're telling me you're in one Nigeria. What stupid one Nigeria is that? What stupid. Sheru Sani tweeted a message. People living in the outskirts of Abuja were told by DSS not to panic and run when they were about to see headsmen on transit. Headsmen on transit with AK-47 inside Abuja. DSS. Why? Because it's being controlled by Fulani. I know the foolish arrogance and pride of the Fulani will lead them to come to Biafra land, and there they will die. I'm telling you the truth. They will die there. Excessive pride is what's going to kill them, and nemesis will consume them in our land. I'm telling you that Nigeria is dead as a result of Fulani foolishness and pride. The most backward, un-indigenous tribe in Nigeria coming to conquer the owners of the land. I will not have it. I will not have it. I'm telling you the truth. God knows in heaven. I will not have it. Fulani cannot take 1 inch of Biafra land. Fulani can never ever take 1 inch of Biafra land. They cannot take it. DSS is colluding with them, writing a letter to villagers telling them not to panic. DSS abducting people to India by one Nigeria. Our people cannot see because they are foolish. Fulani wants to take our land. Can't you see it? Can't you see it? I'm asking you. Can you not see it? The zoo is dead and can never, ever be resurrected. Lia Shuaibu is in captivity. Had Lia Shuaibu been a Muslim girl by now, every Christian in the north would be killed. But she is still in captivity. And all I hear stupid Christian pastors saying is tithe and offering. One Nigeria, one Nigeria. Whereas a Christian girl is in captivity. In captivity. The same thing cannot happen to a Muslim girl. Nothing. The same DSS kidnapping people are the ones granting passage to terrorists in Niger State and in Abuja. The same people. Don't take my word for it. It was tweeted by a Fulani man, an ex-Fulani senator, Sheikh Hussaini. What does that tell about one Nigeria? What does it tell you about one Nigeria, I'm asking you?
Because anybody talking about one Nigeria is a child of Lucifer. If you talk about one Nigeria, you are a child of Lucifer. That means there is no God inside you. If there is God inside you, how can such a thing be happening in Nigeria now? How is that possible? How is that possible? I'm asking you. And you claim you're a child of God, you couldn't say it. Some of them claim we are children of God, we are this, we are that, we are prophets. You could not see, you couldn't have predicted. You're only coming out now to say, oh, don't worry, Nigeria will not break. Nigeria is not going to break. Now the camera cannot break Nigeria. Someday we cannot break Nigeria. Did I tell you I was going to break Nigeria? God will destroy Nigeria because his glory cannot be taken by man. Some of these stupid, idiotic prophets claim they are prophets. They're like Pharaoh. They're even worse than Pharaoh. They read the Bible. They claim they are Bible scholars. They read the Bible. But they don't understand what the Bible is talking about. Because they worship the god of mammon, the god of money. Tithes and offerings, that's all they're interested in. Private jets and flashy cars. They're not even ashamed. And I said to them many years ago, Elohim said, let my people go. And I went on to add, if you do not let us go, Nigeria will be worse than Somalia. I made it very clear. I don't believe in stupid, prophetic pronouncement. Very clean and clear. Somalia will be better than the zoo called Nigeria. If you don't let our people, if you don't let the children of God go, God will visit his anger. People don't know, as I told Britain something. Regardless of their first world state, I said to Britain, if you continue to meddle into the affairs of Biafra, God will divide Britain into pieces. Will cut Britain into pieces. But your pride, you will know it is because of Biafra, but your pride will not allow you to come out to say publicly it's because of Biafra. God will destroy Britain. Before all the whole world, you will see it. Now they have realized their mistakes, that they are going back, little by little, of course. God will destroy Nigeria beyond redemption. Many of you shouting one Nigeria, you're going to die. Many of you will die. Because of that one Nigeria, you're going to die. They have killed us many years ago. Now they are going to die. And then after that, Biafra will come. I told you this in 2014. And it's happening before our eyes this very day. As always, remember that we have no other religion other than Biafra. Biafra is our religion. And here on radio, Biafra is where we worship. Because Elohim, Chukwokikabiamapurumi Heninenoligwe, is our God. With all the love in my heart, believe it or not, with all the love in my heart, from me, from here, good evening. We are Nigeria.